Hey guys, welcome back to Up and Above. In today's video, I want to show you guys how do you install a surface mount outlet, the proper box to use, and how to get it done the right way, and how to pass inspection. So the first thing I did was dropping the Y behind the wall. So the beautiful thing about this is behind the sheetrock, they have plywood. So I'm able to secure my box using drywall screws. I don't need to put anchors. In most cases, you will need blue anchors or toggle bolt, but I didn't need it. So now I gotta add two more boxes. For me to add two more boxes, because the surface mount, I could use maybe a short BX, but what I'm gonna do is using an offset nipple, 3/4 inch, to link to the other box and then to the third box. Once I finish doing that, then I'm gonna secure them to the wall as well and check for level, make sure my lock nut is tight. As you can see, I'm using a Klein level. What I love about this level, it has a strong magnet. So once you put it in the box, it holds very strong and steady. It won't fall like most level, which is one of the reasons why I really love Klein tools. As you can see, I finished installing all my boxes. So now what I'm gonna do is install a ground tail on each box. It is very important that you also put a ground tail to the box and splice it with the existing ground that is coming from the panel, and you create a tail for each devices. So now what I'm doing is I'm sending another piece of wire on the other side so I could link all the outlets. So in the first box, I'm gonna take this ground with the ground that's going into the box, I'm gonna splice it. So I'm gonna create two tails because I'm adding a quad outlet on each boxes. So the owner buy these cheap outlets. I call them lazy for lazy people, but it is what it is. All you gotta do is open the clips, you push in the wire, and then you close it. You don't have to use a screwdriver or anything like that. All you gotta do is strip the wires, and then ready to go. I don't like those outlets, but hey, that's just my preference. Let me know in the comment below what you think about those type of outlet, if you installed them before, if you like them, or if you think if we shouldn't use them at all. So whenever you're doing surface mount outlet, it depends on the situation. In my case, as you can see here, the ground tail is going to the box. I create my tails, everything, each one is going to an outlet. So that right there, meet code, so we're good to go. So the next thing I'm going to do is install a Mulberry cover. So before you can install a Mulberry cover, you have to cut the ears of the outlet so it could fit. So if you don't, you won't be able to fit. Unfortunately, they don't make outlets specifically for Mulberry covers. You just gotta cut the ears and then you'll be able to install your Mulberry cover. So as you can see on my first go, I didn't properly cut the ears. I'm having a little bit difficulty times. So what I'm gonna have to do is cut it some more, because these outlets come with an extra white layer and just make life a little bit more difficult versus the regular outlet. Or once you cut the metal, you already know where to cut because everything is outlined. And this one, you gotta keep cutting till everything fit. You know what I'm saying? Now let's see if you fit. I'll cut some more. Finally got it to fit after cutting it a few different times. So the good thing about this Mulberry cover, it comes with its own little nut you put in the back. Unfortunately, you gotta use the screws that come with the outlet so you can screw it in. As you continue to watch this video, guys, I want you guys to know that I appreciate all the support. And those who haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. Be part of the community as we continue to grow. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Until the next time, peace.